schnell!
Erdgeschoss gesichert!
Etagen verbarrikadiert!
Thank you.
Major! Und weiter vorwärts!
Oberster Stock, sicher! Das Gebäude ist sicher, Genossen. Wir müssen uns auf den Gegenangriff vorbereiten. Verteidigungspositionen einnehmen! Wir haben es! Sehr gut, Genossen! Wir haben heute Glück gehabt! Ruht euch aus!
Morgen haben wir vielleicht kein Glück mehr.
Wir kommen auf das Dorf zu. Seien Sie bereit zum Einsteigen und...
Du bist in Ordnung.
Komm schon, lass uns gehen. Alle neu gruppieren. Okay, Leute. Unsere Panzer können mit den Waffen nicht weitergehen. Echter Trupp unter Druck, die Waffe, wird der Trupp versucht, sie durch die Baumgrenze zu flankieren. Verstanden? Wie?
Feinde!
Gute Arbiter, raumt nun die Gebäude entlang der Hauptstraße. Unsere Panzer werden die Feuerwehr unterstützen. Wir können die Waffe nicht frontal nehmen, einen Weg finden, die Crew zu flankieren und sie auszuschalten.
Yeah.
gesagt mit Arbeit. Wir haben noch nach ein Handvoll Gebäuden und das dort geheut und.
Unser letzter Panzer.
Lass sie beseilen!
Gegenangriff! Vertätige dieses Dorf!
Arbeit heute, Soldaten, ich alle. Die Franzosen haben hart gekämpft, aber wir haben euch ergalten. Wir haben viele gute Männer und Panzer verloren, die dieses Dorf mitnahmen. Also will ich es nicht verlieren. Ruhen Sie sich kurz aus und schaffen Sie ein Verteidigungslinie um das Dorf, bis Versteckung entrifft.
Thank you.
I need your help. Do what I say, and we can avenge this massacre. My injured hand means I can no longer aim. You will do it for me. Take my rifle and watch the road. No Modak in the car is General Heinrich Amsel, architect of Stalingrad's misery. He is responsible for the cold-blooded murder of men, women, and children. Not just here, but throughout the motherland.
For 3 days, I have hunted him. For 3 days. Luck alone has saved his wretched life. Sniping your enemy is like hunting any other animal.
Fire at the wrong moment and your chance will be forever lost. Patience.
If we reveal our position to Amsel's men, this fountain will be our grave.
Now, load your rifle, but hold your fire.
Wait until the bombers are directly overhead. The sound of the engines would drown out your shot.
Ready? Shoot! Now! Again! Strike ahead!
Excellent aim. You are a natural hunter.
In for the kill. This way.
Jot. Some armored patrol. We must find another route to Amsel.
Stay low. And follow me.
This way. Before they discover the dead.
For days, I have crept through shadows like a rat.
This place, once echoed with conversations of friends and lovers. No longer. Mark my words, comrade. One day things will change. We will take the fight to their land. To their people. To their blood.
This way. Knowing the routines and movements of your prey tips the balance of a hunt. General Amsel is a creature of habit. He inspects each German garrison every day.
We can use this building to flank his route.
Sniper! Get inside now!
Son, it's almost got me. We'll have to flush him out before we move on.
Follow me!
The shot came from across the river. There! The building with the banners!
Now the game is cat and mouse.
I will draw his fire. Keep your eyes open for the flash. Ready? Now!
Good hunting!
The patrols will surely have heard those shots.
We need to get moving. German patrol. Let them pass.
Get ready!
They found us! We need to leave now!
Hit the floor!
They are trying to burn us out! Stay long! Try not to breathe!
Her mit dem Flammenwerfer! Verbrennt diese Russenschweine!
Dimitri! We thought you were among the dead in the massacre at the square!
He was! Among them, but not one of them.
We're about to assault the communication post north of here.
Good! Such a move will prevent the German command calling for help. Dimitri and I will provide cover from above. Wait till you hear the screams of dying Germans. Dimitri, this way! Up the ladder!
This way, comrades! Take positions and wait for the signal!
Hold your fire. Do you see the flamethrowers? You must choose.
Excellent aim, Dimitri! Give covering fire to our comrades below!
Come on! Come again!
Deckung!
More infantry! Cut them down! We must cut off his escape route!
Los, los, los!
Sniping position, overlooking the command post. Hold fire!
We are too close to our goal to reveal our position.
There is nothing we can do for our comrades. Their sacrifice will not go unavailed.
The death of General Absel will be just the beginning.
Look ahead! The building adorned with flags is the German command post.
General Absel will soon be
sounds of battle and slashing out.
Coward! There he is!
Sir, he's not alone. Put a bullet in his bodyguard's head.
The Mudak is using the destroyed tank for cover. He's running! You are a true marksman!
They will be coming for us! We must go! Quickly! Before their tanks fire again!
Die, you scum-sucking animal!
Into the river, Dimitri! It is our only chance!
Go!
game, Oscar!
I'll track them!
Und jetzt weiter!
Und weiter vorwärts!
Come on.
Sie sind ein Glückskind, Vasili. Gut gemacht.
Okay, Genosse. Hier ran. Gehen wir.
Für Mütterchen Russland.
Los jetzt! Genossen, wir haben heute Glück gehabt. Ruht euch aus.
Thank you.
Hey! Gott sei Dank! Es ist vorbei! Tapfere Genosse Vasili, heute scheinen wir noch mal Glück gehabt zu haben. Jedenfalls bis jetzt.
Thank you.
Their left flank! Here I come!
Tot stinken sie noch erbärmlicher. Kommt, lasst uns hier verschwinden, bevor sie nochmal angreifen.
Töten wir sie. Genau wie diese dreckigen Schweine.
Was kaputt?
Nur billigen Plunder, der sie wohl an ihre Heimat erinnern sollte.
Nein! Russisches Schwein, du hättest lieber tot bleiben sollen.
Was ist das?
Dmitri! Finish those rats!
Once again! You cheat death! Our tanks are ready to smash this line and...
Chernov! I am not hearing gunshots!
There is no point, Sergeant. They are already bleeding to death.
Then maybe our friend will help them bleed faster.
Burn the wheat field! There will be no escape! Shoot!
I need to shoot them in the back!
The back, the front, the head, whatever you will! Just so long as they are dead!
Things have changed, my friend. Now it is their land. Their people. Their blood.
I flash burning bone!
Hunt them down like that rats there! Find the bird!
An attack! Attack off!
Sowjetische Truppen! Into the river!
I know to trust your instincts, Dmitri.
Left or right, you lead the way.
Thank you.
the charge! I see time has not weakened your aim. You can learn much from this man, Chernov. Break open the door. The cowards may hide in shadows, but we will find them. Shoot! Another tank! Dimitri, take it down! Fire the Panzerschreck!
Sergeant Reznov, you seem to relish in the slaughter.
I've seen my friends die in front of me at the hands of this world. They deserve everything they get, and more. Dimitri, ride on one of the tanks. You have earned the rest. Chernov, you have not. You walk.
Follow the Rupert's example! Now, it's coming! It's a
destroyed to pieces before they take position!
Thank you. Sport! Straight ahead!
Command armor!
Straight ahead!
Two more idiot shockwaves! Another tank!
Berlin! Hurrah!
Fortune smiles on us! In Berlin, the Germans will truly see what they have unleashed. In the midst of all the blood, the bullets, and the dead, I found that an old friend was still very much alive. Dmitry Petrenko, I saw this man cheat death time after time at the siege of Stalingrad. As long as he lives, the heart of this army cannot be broken. He makes us all proud. On your feet!
On the Führer's birthday, a barrage of Katyusha rockets will tear Berlin to pieces! With your bullets, with your bayonets, with your bare hands, do the same to their wretched soldiers!
Use them for cover!
The rats are everywhere!
Clear everything!
Board to the upper floor!
Keep
This place reeks of nightmares and madness. But only the insane would stand against us.
This way, upstairs! Dimitri, grab a shotgun. We will be killing at close quarters.
Shh! Do you hear something?
No. That is why I am suspicious. Move carefully, comrade.
Inside!
up!
Shh! Move quietly. Take them by surprise.
Die russischen Soldaten rücken immer weiter vor.
Wir sind fast vollständig umsinkelt.
Unsere Lage ist aussichtslos.
Ist das, was ich den General erklären sollte?
Da sind sie! Zu Herzen!
Room clear!
Killing me will not save. My comrades show no mercy.
Your comrade.
In Stalingrad, Dmitri and I go through many smoke-filled buildings.
Do you hear him complaining?
Come on.
They are all dead!
Kill them all! Wipe this scum from the streets! Chernov, what is going on?
These men are trying to surrender!
Look around you, Chernov. Do you think these men will be denied their revenge? Death comes only two ways. Fast or slow.
Chernov, you should learn from Dmitri. He understands the nature of mercy kill.
Quickly! Into the metro! This way! You will be okay! Do you hear me? They flooded their own metro in an effort to kill us, Dmitri. But once again, they failed. Once more, we cheat death. You will be okay. Relax for a few minutes. Breathe deeply. Which do you think will lead us home? Writing about this war or fighting it? No one will ever read this! If you lack the stomach to kill for your country, at least show me that you are willing to die for it!
Sergeant!
Take the left flank and eradicate whatever scum remains in defense of each building.
Yes, Commissar.
You heard him, comrades! To the left! We are in the final hours of Berlin's downfall! We must all play our part!
Find the strength! Do whatever it takes!
should lead this.
Move inside! This is what you came here for! Kill them all! Bound them to die!
April 30th, 1945. When he first spoke of Dmitri, Reznov told tales of a hero. Someone we should all aspire to be like. At times, I have seen him show mercy, and at others act with complete brutality. I do not understand him. Perhaps heroes need not question their actions.
Steel yourselves, men, for the final push to victory. Today, we crush what remains of their fascist right. As heroes, we will return to Russia's embrace. Our land, our people, our blood.
The Fatherland needs your final commitment! The SS Honor Guard defending this building will fight to their last breath, crush the last remnants of resistance, and this night our flag will fly over the city! We must falter!
Every strong point they can! I bet! Give them a little!
Get them over now!
Push! Being held from the other side! I need help!
Go! Everyone, through the doors!
Go forward!
Throw these animals over the edge!
Sergeant, our comrades from the rear echelon are flooding the building.
Let them feast on our scraps. We should push on to
victory! The flooding part! On the branches, their fire will not speak for the last time!
This army can never be broken.
Things will change, my friend. As heroes, we will return to Russia's embrace.
Thank you.
Jerry!
Watch out!
Try the ground!
Follow me!
Okay, a lot of this I owe to somebody called Simon Newman, whom I've never met, and who wrote an extraordinary piece of work as his PhD thesis called The British Guarantee to Poland of 1939. And his analysis of what took place and of the what was going through the minds of the British government at the time that we made this guarantee to Poland is devastating. And if you can get hold of it, which is very difficult, I recommend it to you. But what runs through it and what shocked me in the way that, you know, sitting late at night over a book, sometimes something really does deliver a shock to the mind, was the discovery that not merely, because this is easily discovered, not merely had we made a guarantee to Poland which we had no intention whatsoever of fulfilling. We could not have helped Poland in 1939 if we'd wanted to. We didn't plan to do so. Our military leaders knew that we couldn't, our political leaders knew that we couldn't, yet we still made this guarantee. Not merely did that guarantee give Poland control over the exact time and place of the beginning of the Second World War, which it did, that's also known, but that we made the guarantee because we were afraid that Poland would come to a friendly understanding with Nazi Germany. And we were worried that we would therefore not have a pretext for a war, which we sought because we wished to reassert our position as a major power. And this is clear from minutes of cabinet meetings and of discussions between major figures in British foreign policy at the time. I would fundamentally attribute it to Lord Halifax, though it's quite clear that Neville Chamberlain was involved in the first place.